Hi guys, Vikas over here and you are watching We Are Genius. Guys, this is the final video in the series IoT with Raspberry Pi and that is using Java. If you have watched the other videos in the series, you know the series is divided into sensor interfacing using Pi4J, REST API usage with Java, MQTT usage with Java and finally adding all to the same project and running our Raspberry Pi. In the last videos, we saw how to interface DS18B20 1-watt temperature sensor with Raspberry Pi. That is using Pi4J and Java, and after that we checked how to send data to ThingSpeak by using REST API, and we did the same with MQTT API by using Eclipse Pahoo. If you have not checked those, please check those first before checking out this video, and for those I have provided the links down below in the description. This video is the final one in the series where we will complete the project by combining the codes developed in the earlier videos. And we'll make the application such that we can decide the API that we will be using to publish the data to thingspeak.com. So, being said that, let's get started, guys. So, guys, to start with this, let's open up Eclipse. And this is the project that we created earlier, starting from video number one, that is with IoT Raspberry Pi. Created a package that holds the class that interacts with the sensor. Then you created the class that will handle the REST calls, that is using REST in the second video. And in the third video, we saw how to use MQTT API by using Eclipse Pahoo. So over here, I'll just modify the project so that we'll be able to use REST or MQTT API depending upon our requirement. So over here, I'll just uncomment this thing. So that we commented earlier in the videos, and I'll just modify the main class so that we'll be sending our data through the API that we require or we prefer. So over here I'll just take advantage of the command line parameters that we'll be passing through the application when we try to run it out. So to do that, I'll just check out if x0 dot equals. So over here I'll be checking if the parameter that we passed when we execute the application is MQTT or REST. So if it is MQTT, we'll try to send the data using the MQTT interface, otherwise we'll be using the REST interface if it is mentioned REST. Sorry, this has to be aux0, and let's move these things over here to object initializations and all. Similarly, I'll just move this thing over here. Just do this thing over here. Okay. Now I'll just copy this thing and I'll write down REST over here. This will be executed else, and I'll have another else statement that will print out we have not selected any interface to send out our data. So if MQTT is selected, it will send the data by using the MQTT interface. If REST is selected, it will send the data using REST, otherwise it will simply print out that no interface is selected. And over here it will just print out sending temperature data using MQTT, and for this it will just print out sending temperature data using REST. And if nothing is selected, it will just print out no interface. face is selected. Okay. Now let's put everything on a while loop so that it will send the data forever unless we close the application. And over here I'll mention another thing, that is if no interface is selected, it will just print out the data once and it will exit. Okay. Now over here we are sending the data in a while loop, so I'll just add some delay so that we'll not get the data in second. So to do that, I'll just add some delay using thread.sleep, and that delay will be something like, for timing I'm using just making it 1 minute, but you can just increase it to 15 or 30 minutes depending upon your requirement. So it will just throw exception, so let's handle it, add those declaration, and that's all with that's pretty much all about the code. Okay, we just need to modify this. We just need to mention temp over here. And over here also, we just need to mention temp. So let's create the executable jar file and we'll just transfer the file to Raspberry Pi and we'll try to run it there. So over here, just create the executable file. Again, if you are new to Java application development on Raspberry Pi, you should check out my all your tutorials on this. Now let's upload the generated jar file and the leaf folder to Raspberry Pi. And over here I'm using WinSCP, but you can use any software application that you are acquainted with. So let's open up Putty and we'll run our application on Raspberry Pi. To do that, I'll just use the command sudo java path to the application, that is on desktop test.jar, the application name. And for the first run, I have not mentioned any interface to publish data. That's why it is just printing out the temperature. And as we have not passed any parameter, it is telling that index out of bound exception error because we have not passed any argument. So let's close it. Okay. So now let's try to run the application and we'll mention REST so that we'll try to publish the data by using the REST interface or REST API. So it is printing out, sending the temperature data using REST, and it has successfully sent the data. So let's check on thingspeak.com and see if we have received the data. So I'll just get into my channels and get into the REST API channel where I am sending the data. And you can see over here, the last entry is less than a minute ago. That means it must have successfully sent the data. Just need to check on the graph if you are getting that. And you can see over here, it is it has sent the temperature, that is 31 degrees Celsius for the time being. Yep. Okay, let's close the application and we'll try to run the application, but this time we'll be sending out the data by using MQTT interface. And to view the data, let's get into the other channel that is receiving the same data by using the MQTT interface or MQTT API. And let's get into this. Yeah, over here also you can see it has received data less than a minute ago. And if you check over here, it is received data, that is 31 degrees Celsius, and the temperature currently is that much only. So that's all with this. The application worked out successfully and we are able to send data to thingspeak.com by using REST as well as MQTT API. So one more thing, if you want to run the application whenever the Raspberry Pi boots up, you can do that by using crontab or any other method. And for that also I have published one video on that, like how to auto start applications when the Pi boots up. So I'll just be providing the link down below in the description. Make sure to check that out if you want. So that's all about this. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have please hit the thumbs up button, and if you have not subscribed yet, you can definitely subscribe to my channel for latest updates and videos like this. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.